A very good morning to class 12th commerce. Today I am going to teach you about the first topic, that is partnership accounts. Partnership accounts. Already, I have explained the topic profit and loss appropriation account in my previous videos. But today I will just tell you about the fundamental of the partnership. Partnership, that is known as partnership firm. In class 11th already you have learned about the sole trade. In sole trade, there is single owner, single person invests the capital. He invests his experience, his skill, talents, whatever he has, and he is alone in the business. We can say in a very simple language. So, to remove the demerits of the sole trade, or to expand the business for a big business, another type of the business organization is there, that is known as partnership. Partnership, that is the simple meaning I will explain, meaning of the partnership. So, partnership is voluntary association. Voluntary association. Association of persons. Voluntary association of person. And the second thing, agreed to share the profit of the business. First thing, it is voluntary association of the person, and they are agreed to share the profit of the business. Business is compulsory. When there is business, then only partnership is formed. Partnership firm is formed only for the business. Means, first of all, the business is decided. And the third thing, the business is carried on by all persons or any one of them, on behalf of all. First thing, it is voluntary association on sweet will. Second thing, sharing the profit. Third thing, business is required. And that is the main focus, or the main thing, that when there is business, then only partnership is formed. The business is carried on by all the partners or any one of them on behalf of all. Means one can lead the business, or all can lead the business. One thing I would like to tell you, that there is a partnership the total partnership business, here I will write, it is known as partnership firm. It is known as partnership firm. There is an act to govern the total partnership business, and the act is Indian Partnership Act 1932. There is already an act in the Constitution that is known as Indian Partnership Act 1932. But there are some changes in year 2013. Some amendments are made in year 2013 as per changes. Some changes are made in year 2013 as per Company Act 1956. One more thing I would like to tell you, as it is taught in class 11, that there is no need of the registration of the sole trade, but registration that is optional. Optional means we can register the firm or that is not required. It is all optional. As per Company Act 1932, the partnership firm can be registered or cannot be registered. Now I will just tell you some characteristic of the partnership firm in very short. Characteristics. The first thing, that there is agreement. And the second thing, sharing of the profit. Sharing profit. Or I can say this is third, the second number, that there should be a business. Sharing profit and there should be business and sharing profit. Agreement, as I have told you, that the Indian Partnership Act 1932, the total business is governed under the Act, that is 1932. But the agreement can be made by partners. Business has to be decided and the sharing profit, that is the compulsory. And each partner is agent. Each partner is agent. As I have written here, the business is carried on by all persons or any one of them. So each partner is agent of the firm. So this is the simple, these are the characteristics. More characteristics are there. You can see the book and you can learn. Now I would like to tell you about the Partnership Agreement and Partnership Act. There are some rules given in the Partnership Act 1932. So, now I am just I will remove this and I will tell you about the partnership agreement and partnership deed. Rules as per Partnership Act 1932 and the some amendments as per 2013 changes. Some rules are mentioned in the Partnership Act 1932. So here I will explain only the rules which are applicable in the practical questions. Profit and loss that is shared equally. As per Partnership Act 1932, profit or loss that is shared equally among the partners. The second, interest on capital or drawings. As per Partnership Act 1932, there is no provision on interest on capital and interest on drawing. That is no. Third, rules as per the Partnership Act 1932, salary, commission or any other remuneration. No partner is given salary or commission or any type of remuneration in any condition as per act. Fourth, interest on partners loan. Interest on partners loan, sometimes when firm is required financial help or financial support from outsider or from the partners. So the loan can be taken, the firm can take loan from the partner. So when any partner has given loan to the firm, here I would like to tell you that firm is a separate unit and the partners, they are others. These are partners and this is firm. So any one of the partners that can give the loan to the firm. So when a partner, any partner has given loan to the firm, interest at the rate of 6% per annum will be allowed to that partner. Sixth number, one more thing, not as per the rule, minimum number of partners that is two and maximum that was 20, but now it is cancelled, and now the new maximum number is decided, that is 50. As per Partnership Act 1932, the maximum number of partners, that was 20, minimum that is 2, still it is 2, and previously it was 20, but now as per the amendment changes made in 2013, that is 50. So these are the rules applicable as per the Partnership Act 1932. My dear students, the practical questions are made as per the Partnership Act 1932 if there is no provision of the partnership deed. Means a new term, that partnership deed, or it is known as partnership agreement. Rules, that is as per act, and partnership deed is a document prepared by the partners, and they may write all the rules or regulation as per their own convenience. So in the reference of the rules, either the questions are solved as per the act, or the questions are solved as per the partnership deed. Deed is made by partners, and rules, that is made by the government, that is Act 1932. The first thing, profit or loss, that is as per agreed ratio, which can be decided by the partners. Interest on capital or drawing, the second. Interest on capital or drawings. Can be allowed or charged. Interest on capital is allowed and interest on drawing is charged. It is already mentioned, or it is taught in class 11 in the topic of financial statement. Salary, commission, etc. The third one, salary, commission, etc. Can be given as per partnership deed. Interest on partner's loan, that is same as per Partnership Act 1932, that may be increased or decreased. Fourth number, interest on partner's loan. Partner's loan, 6% per annum or plus or minus, that may be increased or that can be decreased. Minimum number actual, that is not in the rule, that is the actual partnership, the concept of the partnership. So here I am just telling you that the practical questions, there are so many other rules as per the partnership act, and there are so many points of partnership deed. Deed is known as partnership agreement. Some rules related to practical questions I have mentioned here. So the question can be solved either by this or by this, which is mentioned in the question. But when nothing is written in the question, no instruction is there, the total question is solved as per the Partnership Act 1932 or as per the instruction, and those instructions are according to partnership deed or partnership agreement. Pause. So here, my dear students, we have discussed about the meaning of the partnership characteristic, and I have explained some rules of partnership as per Partnership Act 1932, and I have just mentioned few items of the partnership deed. These are very few. There are so many points in the partnership deed or partnership agreement, and same in the partnership act. So you can see the book and you can learn those points. This is enough for this period, and we will talk about the general entries in the next video. So thank you very much, my dear student. Take care.